When James and I divorced, it was tough, but we managed to keep things civil for the sake of our sons, Richard and Ryan. Co-parenting hasn't always been easy, but we made it work. Things changed when he married Barbara, who already had 3 kids from a previous marriage. They also had 2 more children together, making for a very full house. I knew life would be different for Richard and Ryan with such a big blended family. I was prepared for the adjustments that would come with it. What I wasn't prepared for was James expecting me to help cover the costs for kids that aren't mine. The first sign of trouble came when James started asking for all of Richard and Ryan's hand-me-down clothes. "It just makes sense," he said. "They grow out of things so quickly, and Barbara's kids can use them." I didn't mind sending over the clothes my boys had outgrown. But then it started getting out of hand. James would ask for specific items, things that were barely worn, or clothes I had planned to keep as mementos. When I hesitated, he acted like I was being selfish. Things escalated when school started this year. Since James was dropping the boys off for their first day, I sent them with the school supplies they needed. I thought I was doing the right thing by ensuring they had everything. But later that day, James called me. "Mary, you didn't send enough supplies," he said. "What do you mean?" I asked, confused. "I bought everything on their list." "Yeah, but Barbara's kids didn't get everything they needed. You should have picked up extra supplies for them too. They're all going to the same school. It's only fair." I couldn't believe what I was hearing. "James, those aren't my kids. It's not my responsibility to buy their school supplies." He sighed like I was missing the point. "You know our budget is tight with so many kids. It wouldn't have hurt to help out." I bit my tongue, trying to stay calm. "James, if you and Barbara can't afford the basics, maybe Barbara should consider getting a job." That didn't go over well. He got defensive, saying Barbara was busy managing the household and that I was being unreasonable. The final straw came when he asked me to top off Barbara's kids' lunch accounts because all the kids eat together at school, and it's awkward if some of them can't afford lunch. I snapped. "James, your wife's kids are not my responsibility. I already make sure our sons have everything they need. You can't expect me to provide for children that aren't mine. It's not fair to ask." He accused me of being unsupportive and not understanding what it's like to have such a big family. But honestly, I don't think that's my problem. I want to be there for my boys, but I refuse to be guilt-tripped into paying for things that Barbara's kids need. Now I'm wondering, am I the asshole for refusing to pay for necessities for kids that aren't mine? Should I be more understanding of their situation, or was I right to draw the line?